must be terminated.
Can't open it from this end.
I
detected. Curious. Overactive sensors. Nothing more. Still there.
Got it.
Attacking. Isn't my old friend the frozen TV dinner. Last time we met, you were cozying up to the peas and apple cobbler. Sorry, your house has been a wreck for 200 years. I don't need a roommate. Leave. Never expected you to come knocking on my door. Gave you 50-50 odds of making it to Diamond City. After that, figured the Commonwealth would chew you up like jerky.
Hostile sensor reading.
Pissed off, I get it, I do. But whatever you hope to accomplish in here, it's not gonna go your way.
Can't break the code. Got it. Thank you.
Is someone present? Reverting.
You've got guts and determination. It's admirable.
Hostile sensor.
You are in.
Hell yeah.
Here's a thing. A sort of note, I guess, from a sponsor here in Diamond City, and I'll read it. Stop in for a drink at the Dugout Inn. The stories are free. The moonshine will cost you. That's the first by name, Bob Rowe. I kind of feel like the last thing I'd want to do is...
Nice.
Thank you.
You made it. I'm just up ahead. My synths are standing down. Let's talk.
Where is my son? Where is Sean?
Pal, I'm just a puppet like you. My stage is a little bigger, that's all. Sean's a good kid. Bit older than you expected, am I right? But he's doing great. Only, he's not here. He's with the people pulling the strings.
God damn it, you mercenary motherfucker. Where is my son?
What's the cliche? So close, but yet so far away? That's Sean. But don't worry. You'll die knowing he's safe and happy. A bit older than you expected, but ah well. At least he's in a loving home. The Institute.
So where is it, huh? This Institute. How do I get there?
Haven't you been paying attention? You don't find the Institute. The Institute finds you. You open the closet, it's just a closet. You can never find the monster that hides inside. Not until it jumps out at you. But I think we've been talking long enough. We both know how this has to end. So, you ready?
You know, in 100 years, when I finally die, I only hope I go to hell so I can kill you all over again, you piece of shit.
him all this paper.
Access.
Paladin Dance on frequency 9-5. All Brotherhood of Steel units are to return to the Cambridge Police Station immediately for reassignment. Repeating. This is Paladin Dance on frequency 9-5. All Brotherhood of Steel units are to return to the Cambridge Police Station immediately for reassignment. Repeating.
Work to do. Can't talk now.
Call a good day.
Huh?
Hey there.
So what's your story? Looking to trade? Rob me? Or just ask directions to Diamond City?
Just looking for love, sweetheart.
Boy, have you come to the wrong place. My loving days have long since passed. But I'll tell you what, wise ass. You made an old girl smile, and that ain't easy. You want to do some trading? I'll give you a discount.
Just looking.
Whatever.
Try to make myself useful. No one wants to see a grown man feeling sorry for himself.
Nikki, I'm just asking for your opinion. Be a great quote.
He's my client, Piper. Why don't you learn not to snoop on a man's private affairs?
Well, well, speak of the devil.
You're back. And not with your son. What happened?
Where do you want me to start? The part where Kellogg turned out to be working for the Institute? Or the part where he told me they have Sean?
The Institute? Oh, boy.
I'm sorry, friend. Truly. That makes things considerably more complicated.
He ain't kidding. Heck, Nick's a synth, and even he doesn't know how to get in.
No synth does. Security protocols strip those memories out.
I need to find a way.
I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now. The Commonwealth's boogeyman. Feared and hated by everyone.
True enough.
Sometimes they snatch people in the middle of the night, and sometimes they leave old synths behind to remind us that they're out there. But to this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is, or how to get in.
Exactly. But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Sean.
Kellogg? Huh.
You read my mind. He had to have a way in and out.
Yeah, but something tells me he's not gonna drop by for a chat and coffee.
We can talk to him. Feel like holding a seance?
A literal dead end, huh?
So, a murderer and a kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve.
He wasn't gonna talk, even if I had a way of bringing him in alive.
Gets his brains blown out. Huh. His brains. You know, we may not need the man at all.
You're talking crazy here, Nick. Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look, there's a place in Good Neighbor called the Memory Den. Relive the past moments in your mind as clear as the day they happened. If anyone could get a dead brain to sing, it'll be Dr. Amari, the mind behind the memories.
Who's this Dr. Amari?
I'll let her give you her life story in person. Let's stay focused. I Guess we're gonna need a piece of Kellogg's brain. Enough gray matter to bring to Amari and find out if this is going to work.
Jesus, Nick! Gross! Seriously?
I know it's grisly, but what choice do we have? We got no leads, nothing. That old Merc's brain just might have all the secrets we need to know.
Actually, I think I already have something. Kellogg had this thing attached to his head.
Cybernetics, huh? We may have just won the lottery.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can't all go running across the Commonwealth, so who's coming with you?
I have to go to the memory den either way, if I'm going to introduce you to Amari. But if you want to head there together, just say so.
I'll head there on my own.
All right. See you at the den. Don't worry. We're gonna get your boy back. Just a few more steps.
Well, you two are out. I'm gonna do some more research. I'll be at the public if you need me.
Ms. Perkins.
I'm glad you're here. We got a new case while you and Nick were out. Ready to put on the detective hat?
Tell me more.
Our client is a fisherman who lives on the edge of the Commonwealth. Kenji Nakano. Mr. Nakano didn't leave many details. Said he'd go over everything when you meet him. But if you want my guess, missing person case. Guy had a worried look a mile long.
Anything you can tell me about Kenji Nakano?
Just some impressions. He was obviously upset, but he was also in a hurry. Like, he couldn't stand just waiting around. I'm a friend of Nick's. He'll remember me. I need his help right away. And then he was gone. He was muttering something on the way out, but no. I'm not sure it was important.
Come on, Ellie. Don't hold out on me. What did he say?
No. No, I can't remember clearly. Don't want to taint the investigation before it's even started.
So, is the fedora and trench coat mandatory when solving these cases? Because I'm thinking smoking pipe and British accent.
Hey, whatever floats your boat, gumshoe. The Nakano residence is up in the northeast, near the coast. A small fishing house. He said that he and his wife will be waiting for you.